Okay, I set up and turned one end of the spark plugs, the threaded end. I did it over on the mill, and because it had three diameters to turn, so I thought, well, that'll be a real quick, easy way of doing it. So I went ahead and I set a tool bit up, basically the same. I didn't video any of it, but it was the same as turning the electrodes, other than the RPM was a lot lower. But I went ahead and I turned up the three diameters, and then I ran a die over and threaded them all, and I gone on the lathe and center drilled and grilled the hole through. So now I'm going to set up to do the counter bore and turn the one diameter on this side. I'm going to do that on a lathe. I have a little holder that this threads into. It's a split collet that with the threads. So I just thread it into the collet. I'll plunge in with a drill, finish it with a boring bar, and then turn the OD. So when I get those done, it's just basic turning and running with a boring bar. But once I get ready to swage them in, I'll come back and I'll show you how I go about that. Before I swage them in, though, I think I'm going to take and cut the electrode end also. Do I want to cut the electrode in first? Can't remember how the steps I did last time, but because I could cut that the electrode tang on here, you know, by cutting the two sides. That means, yeah, I can do that. I might do that. Anyway, when I get ready to swage them, I'll come back and I'll video that, and that'll be with the swaging tool here, and basically all that what that'll be doing is I'll be putting it into the swaging tool, putting a blank in or a end in, but that'll be naturally be sunk down in the countersink or counter bore, and then I'll put the sleeve on it, and then I'll put the form tool down in there, and then I'll squeeze it. So when I get going doing that, I'll video that, because that's a little more than just turning and machining. But like I say, that worked really good on the mill for turning those three diameters too. It just took me longer to load them and unload them than it did to turn them. I did it in two passes on a rough and finish on all the diameters, so it worked out real well. So my mill's getting a little bit of use. I hardly use it, so what else to say other than I'm going to go ahead and start working on the counter bores and turning that one last diameter on the other end, which that's just, like I say, that's just, I'm just gonna plunge in with a drill to the depth, flat bottom it with a boring bar, and then turn the OD. So when I get that done, I'll be back and we'll do some cutting. Oh, I might show you the cutting of the tang too. So anyway, until then, catch you later. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I'm setting up and cutting the tangs now, and see if I can. Back it up a little bit. Trying to, but what I'm doing is I'll cut them. and then I bend it over. So I'm over on the mill. We'll go over to the mill here and I'll show you how I'm doing that. I got the mill set up over here. And I got a, it's a 5C collet indexer. So what I do is I got it set for 0 and then 180 and then back to 90. So we start out at 0, lock the position, and I'll put part in there. I have a stop set in the collet, so that it goes to the right depth. So I just push it in against the stop, tighten it up. I've got my height set. What I did was I took a light cut, measured it, and then let's say it was at 40 thou. I wanted to go to 30. So that would be 10 thou. So I raise the knee up 5 thou, because you'll be take 5 off each side. So you want to make sure that you're only taking half of what you're to the number that you want to get to. And I'm just cautiously going across. Okay, that was at 0. Now we'll flip it. 180, and we'll go across again very carefully. Last time I made plugs, I had a hard time bending that tang without breaking them, so I went a different route. But since then I have found material that actually forms pretty good. And it's just a type of cold rolled steel. So, and then I went to 90 now, and I'm milling off the tang on the one side. And there it is. Loosen the collet up. Take it out. Now I have to deburr the hole, so I just run a drill back through it by hand, and then I go and I form the tang. Let's go over the surface plate here. I will show you how I've been forming the tang. First off, I just go from the back side here and run the drill through. Sometimes they're a little bit of a bitch to get the burr out of there. Still haven't gotten the burr. It's got a hanger there that. Sometimes if you take the drill and just give it a couple taps, it'll knock that burr off of there. But this one is getting, every time that I turn the camera on, it wants to be difficult on whatever I'm doing. I haven't had one this difficult. Must be a sign my cutter's getting dull. It can't be. It ain't taking that much material. There we go. It finally let loose. So now there's the burr's gone on there. So now what I do, move this off to the side. I've got a feeler gauge that I'm gonna tap that down. But the first thing I do is I grab it with the pliers and get it started, and I go about halfway up on it. halfway up on it and just get it started bending inward. See, you know, it's slightly bent inwards. And I put my feeler gauge in there that the gap that I want set, and I hold that down on the top of the plug. And then I just tap that around. And there we go. And then the next thing I do is I go ahead and I put it in my extension here again. I tighten that up, and I know the threads are already on there, but I still put a little dab of Moly D on there, and then I take the die, and I'm just gonna straighten out that thread where the from milling it kind of messes up that first thread. So I'm just gonna go in and with the die, if I can get it started here. Sometimes it's a bitch to get it started. Got to pick up the right thread here. There we go. Oop, I thought I had it there. I should have actually maybe threaded these after I... There we go. And I just turn it in. And I'll just make sure that the threads on the end are fine. And off of there. Take it out. Give it a little spritz of air. Blow the stuff away. And here we go. This one is, if it's going to focus here or not, this one here is ready for the insulator now. So you just take the insulator. Oops, wrong one here. That was an old practice one that... Here we go. And this one hasn't been bored yet on the end. So it has to be bored out yet. I took a drill to the depth, and now I got to take a boring bar and bore it, and then show you one that I've already bored. Yeah, right here. This one has been bored out. And you take and stick the insulator in there. So anyway, I'm going to continue. I've got a few more to do. So I'm going to just continue on. I'll just cut them all, and then when I bore them, I'll show you. I have to bore that counter bore and then turn the OD for the forming tool. So that's where I'm at. That's what I'm doing. So I'm going to continue on. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys later. Okay, I'm going to go back over to the lathe now, and I'm going to plunge a boring bar in and flatten that counterbore out. I have a collet here. It's a split collet and it's threaded. So I just thread the part in, and then when I clamp it up, it'll grip that by the thread. So I just turn it in, and then I come over to the lathe. Lathe here. daisy up a little bit. Maybe. That way you can look down and see what I'm doing. It's just basically, it's, I stick the, and there's a stop in here also now. So I just take and push that in against the stop. I have my diameter's already set. So, over here, a little touch. Set our indicator over there, and we're going to go 95 thou deep. 70, 80, 95. And that's pretty much it. Take it back out of there. Take it out. It's flattened out. And I'll go through all of them and do that, and then when I get done with that, then I'll turn the little collar on here that's going to be the swaged collar, the swages, swage it in and locks the insulator in. But the insulator should slide in that and in through the counter bore just like that. So we're on our way. I'm going to go ahead and do all those, and then we'll come back on the next step. I don't know if I'll come back, because on the next step, the next step will be putting them back in this, each one, and turn that collar up. I'll come back when we're going to swage. So, catch you later. Okay, I have them turned up, so we're going to swage them together. So I'm going to swing around here and we'll look at the vise, because that's where all the action is going to take place. See if I can get you in picture here. Okay, so here's the two parts that we're going to swage together, and here's the swaging tool. So what we do is we take and we put the insulator in into the counter bore. Put that in into the swaging tool. It's got a little shoulder on there, it fits down in there. And then this little sleeve fits on this to keep everything aligned. And then this is the forming tool. And basically that's just a hole, and then it's a ball end mill is what I did and plunged in. So we take and we slide that in. Okay, then we take it down and we put it in the vise. And what I do is I hold on to the alignment and push it down flat, and then tighten the vise up on it. You know, you don't have to reef on it, because it doesn't take much. Just okay. So now I lift this off of here, and it's swaged together tight. And that's the finished product. I don't know if the camera's gonna focus on it or not. There we go. But that's the finished product. Now, well, all we have left is the piano wire electrode that goes through the middle, and a brass cap on the end. So I'll have to cut some wires and turn up some brass caps. Oh, and then we have to mill the hex yet, and I'll use that same threaded bushing. I'll thread that in, mill the, and then go across and mill the hex on there. So, but we're getting there. It's getting closer. So I'm gonna go ahead and swage all the rest of them together. And that's how it's done. how I do it anyway. The swaging tool, basically all the bottom, the anvil, is no more than just a diameter that fits into this alignment to keep everything straight. And the punch itself, the forming punch, that just slides inside that diameter on the alignment to keep everything all lined up straight. Because if you didn't have anything to line it up straight and you were trying to just swage it with like that, with that on there, chances are you're gonna break them. It'll snap it right off, because it doesn't take much to break those. Ask me, I know. I've broke enough of them. So anyway, that's where we're at. Thanks for watching. Catch you later.